In the present video, the theory of the first accurate comprehensive method for computing bond orders, BOs, is going to be explained. BOs help us understand and predict chemical behaviors. For example, in organic chemistry, the bond order is required to determine if a bond can undergo nucleophilic or electrophilic addition, because a multiple bond order is necessary for the addition to happen. Also, the sum of bond orders, SBO, for an atom or material can help us determine its reactivity and other properties. For example, a carbon atom prefers an SBO of around 4, as it has 4 valence electrons to form bonds covalently. This is why carbon monoxide, which has an SBO of around 2.6, is highly reactive and prefers to form carbon dioxide, which has an SBO closer to 4. We are introduced to the concept of bond orders as early as basic chemistry by means of Lewis structures and molecular orbital diagrams. In molecular orbital diagrams, bond order is defined as the number of electrons in bonding minus antibonding orbitals divided by 2. The problem with these heuristics approaches is they assign bond orders only in countable increments. To understand the bond order as a universal concept, they need to be computed, since they represent a set of continuous non-negative real numbers. The most basic example to illustrate this is the bond in a stretch oxygen O2 molecule. As the bond length increases, the bond order should smoothly decrease to 0, instead of being 2 everywhere. Ideally, a method to calculate bond orders need to agree for systems having well-established values. As it can be seen, the new method gives correct results for hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and fluorine gas molecules. Now that we know bond orders need to be calculated, it is important to identify the characteristics a method needs to possess. For a method to compute bond orders to be comprehensive, two main criteria must be met. 1. Handle the general case of non-collinear spin magnetism. And 2. Be an explicit functional of the total electron density and spin magnetization density distributions. But not all previous methods to compute bond orders required electrons to be classified as spin up or spin down. Accordingly, those methods could only be applied to collinear magnetism and did not work for non-collinear magnetism. To fix this problem, electron exchange is formulated in a general way that does not require electrons to be classified as spin up or spin down. This allows bond orders to work for materials with either collinear magnetism and non-collinear magnetism, as well for non-magnetic materials. Some previous methods to compute bond orders were restricted to a specific basis set type and lacked a mathematical limit as the basis set was systematically improved towards completeness. To fix this problem, bond order should be defined to be a functional of the electron and spin density distributions. This will ensure the computed bond order has a well-defined mathematical limit as the basis set used in the underlying quantum chemistry calculation is improved towards completeness. By defining the method to have a complete basis set limit, the bond orders do not explicitly depend on the choice of basis set. This allows the bond order method to work for and give approximately consistent results across various basis set types, including Gaussian functions, plane waves, and others. Bond order quantifies the number of electrons exchanged between two atoms in a material. Here, exchange refers to the quantum mechanical exchange that occurs when two electrons of the same spin switch positions with each other, resulting in the wave function changing sign. Consider the symmetric dihydrogen cation system, H2+. If we quantify the pure exchange of electrons, the bond order would be 1/2, even when these atoms are infinitely apart. As a comprehensive definition, the bond order should decrease to 0 when the electron densities do not overlap each other. Hence, a rescaled exchange, aka Dress exchange, is necessary for the bond order to go to 0 for any two atoms with no density overlaps. Bond orders for molecular hydrogen and dihydrogen cation were calculated using this method and confirmed that bond orders become smaller as the distance between atoms increases. In the new Manz Bond Order equation, the Dress exchange is set to 0 when the atomic electron distributions do not overlap, making the previously explained H2+ bond order 0 when the atoms are sufficiently far apart. The Dress exchange is expressed through a six-dimensional integral, Since directly solving such integral would be computationally expensive, the contact exchange is introduced to facilitate a series expansion in terms of three-dimensional integrals. Contact exchange is a hypothetical exchange if the exchange hole diameter was shrunk to zero, but still excluded one electron. Since the localization of the exchange hole increases the bond order, the contact exchange represents a lower bound on the bond order. Manz showed the bond order equals a multiplier times the contact exchange, where this multiplier's value is between 1 and 2. This multiplier's precise value depends on the atom's coordination number and other factors. Various molecules, organometallic complexes, solids, nanostructured materials, and spin multiplets were studied. These included materials with no magnetism, collinear magnetism, and non-collinear magnetism. Bonding types included covalent, polar, metallic, aromatic, electron deficient, multicenter, hypercoordinate, dative, hydrogen bonding, and stretch bonds. These results show the method is consistently accurate for a wide range of materials and bonding types. Here, the bond orders for different multiplicities and bond length of oxygen O2 were calculated using Manz bond order equation, shown left, and the natural localized molecular orbital, NLMO, shown right. The bond orders calculated in the left decrease as the oxygen atoms are taken far apart. In contrast, when using NLMO, the bond orders jump around as the bond length increases. Two quantum chemistry methods were used to compute the electron and spin density distributions of materials of various spin multiplet values, x-axis. Those distributions were then used to get the bond orders, y-axis, and showed the consistency of the method orders even for different SZ values of a spin multiplet. The Manz bond order method works for different bond types. Here, it was applied to 13 different bond types in organics. The red atoms represent directly connected atoms for which the bond orders were calculated, while black atoms represent adjacent ones. It is shown that across different materials, similar bond types had similar bond order values. This proves the excellent chemical transferability of the method. The VOs and SBOs were also calculated for 7 simple solids, as well as for 20 pure transition metal solids, showing the method also applies to systems with highly delocalized electrons. Here, we can observe that in covalent solids, the SBO of lithium, sodium, and potassium are approximately 1, while for carbon and silicon, it is close to 4. These data are consistent with the numbers of valence electrons these elements have available for covalent bonding. For sodium fluoride and sodium chloride, the SBO is less than 1, because ionic bonding decreases the number of shared electrons compared to covalent bonding. In this plot, the blue curve shows the total computational time for DDEC6 partitioning, including charge partitioning and bond order analysis, increases linearly with increasing number of atoms in the unit cell. The red curve shows the total required random access memory also increases linearly. The orange curve shows the required computational time for just DDEC6 bond order analysis. These results show DDEC6 bond orders can be readily computed for material containing many thousands of atoms in the unit cell. In this study published in 2019, the correlation between density-based bond orders and orbital-based bond energies for chemical bonding analysis are tested. The integrated crystal orbital Hamilton population, ICOP, was computed as the orbital-based bond energy descriptor. Molecules were categorized into different groups. The correlation between the ICOP and the Manz bond order was calculated for each molecule group. Most of the groups exhibited an approximately linear correlation. It was concluded that for a good correlation to exist, 4 key requisites need to be fulfilled. 1. The individual correlations may be constructed for molecules with similar chemical composition. 2. ICOP-BO correlations of carbon-carbon bonds involving beta and gamma carbon atoms can only be constructed when the number of functional groups or the stoichiometry within the functional group remains similar. 3. For molecules containing C-head bonds, with head being a heteroelement down a group, that is, different valence principal quantum numbers, an ICOP-BO correlation may only be established for C-head bonds, but not for other bonds in the molecules. 4. Only for substantially large variations in the VO over ICO values, their direct comparison among the different molecules is possible. The exact threshold depends on particular system investigated and the accuracy of the correlation. Delta VO around 0.2 to 0.25. In this 2019 study, the bond order for 288 diatomic molecules and ions were calculated. Trends in VOs were found across the periodic table. In this graphic, bond dissociation energy versus bond order was plotted for each of the eight main chemical groups. These results show that within each main chemical group, a larger bond order is strongly correlated to larger bond energy. However, this relationship does not hold when comparing molecules from different chemical groups. A heuristic model was also introduced for period 2 homodiatomics, confirming non-integer bond orders for diberyllium, diboron, and dicarbon. This finally provides a fundamental explanation of bond orders for these molecules. In the work entitled A Collection of Force Field Precursors for Metal Organic Frameworks, MOFFS, the bond order method is employed as a screening criterion to either accept or reject a MOFF structure from the 2014 Core MOFF database. If the structure was accepted, a set of force field precursors for the MOFF was created. This table lists accepted SVO ranges for non-metal elements that appear in the database. If an SVO was outside the limits listed, then the MOFF structure was rejected. These are the sources used to support the information in this video. We thank the NSF Career Award for making this video possible.